Game two of the Eastern Conference quarterfinal series with the Panthers is Sunday, April 16th at 7:30 p.m. Once again, all fans are asked to wear white. Game two at the arena is sponsored by Viatel. Tickets are available at the arena box office and all Ticketmaster locations. All right, welcome back, everyone. Matt Lachlan along with the Maven, Stan Fischler, and I'm almost afraid to ask, but where does that goblet stand now?
The goblet broke. It's now a flagon, and it's about a quarter full. But I got to ask you something.
Hold on, before you order it. Listen, we got there's a glass
about,
that's a
you know,
quarter
there are
full.
About 15,000 people in the building, and you went looking for the one guy who's going to put me down.
The one? He's the only one we spoke to.
I mean, how long did it take you to find this guy?
Well, listen. They were lined up by the hundreds, but he
okay.
was the only...
Okay, so I blew it.
Let me read the email. Dear Matt Lachlan, I just wanted to relay a story to you that maybe you could use against Fischler, as you use your first name, on the Matt and the Maven segment. The day before the regular season started this past October, Stan was on Sports Desk with Marv Albert. When asked to give his prediction, Stan said the Rangers would beat the San Jose Sharks to win the Stanley Cup. We all know that this is impossible. Stan gloats about being right the few times that he is. However, he never talks about how wrong he usually is, especially with this joke of a prediction.
Do you want to know why I'm not throwing this at you? Because you're all wet already, okay? That's why.
But you went on a limb.
I looked at the Ranger lineup. I said they should do it. Okay, so I was wrong. Let's talk about this hockey game because... we are at a critical juncture.
Just take a look at the picture. You got the horns coming out of your head.
Yeah, I know.
I'd
like to impale you on the horns of my dilemma.
By the way, keep the emails coming. FoxSportsNY@thegarden.com is the email address. And keep them coming, and we'll get them going. So, all right, so what's the key in the third period?
Well, the key in the third period actually is going to be the penalties or lack of them. You know, the Devils have played two periods without a penalty, and they played good, clean, tough hockey. But, you know, referees like to even things up. And if Florida gets a power play, which I would not be surprised if they do, it's going to be that'll be the critical juncture. Of course, again, we have to focus on the goaltending. I mean, if the defense breaks down, as they did, and not too much in that period, Marty Brodeur made a lot of big saves. But that next save... otherwise, we may be looking at overtime.
Well, you know, of course, that certainly is a possibility. I think this third period will test the Devils' character.
They're
in a contest.
Yeah, right.
They have the early
now, wise guy in the Lachlan, what is that to you?
It's a nice glass of water.
Like I said, he's all wet again.
Agua, the drink of champions.
Another thing, we've got to give credit to Florida. I mean, tenacious, you know, they're not impressed by the home ice of the Devils and forechecking well. And, hey, Mike Vernon only gave up one goal this period.
Well, that was an improvement. He hasn't played well either. Neither goalie has stood out. All right, the Matt and the Maven segment comes to an end. Highlights still to come. Devils over the Panthers after two.